What's up, everybody? Mark Oldmeyer, TigerFitness.com from Koi. Hi, I'm a 33-year-old stay-at-home mom of three kids. That's a hard job. My wife has that. In fact, she'll be 33 when we have three kids. She'll be 32. I don't envy your position. I'd rather be in this office all day long. I weigh 230, and I'm 5'3". Okay, you know, that happened. After three kids, things change. I'm not going to lie. After three kids, it does get a bit harder. I'm going to tell you, some people more than others. Some women just bounce back like the week after, they're back to their fighting weight. Some women, it takes a little more time. Hormones are quite a bear. I have no energy. I would love to lose at least 40 pounds. Can you help me? Usually, I'd be easy. Go to fatlossfactorbook.com and follow it. For you, you have kids. You're going to have kids' food around. You're going to be going in and out of soccer practices and different functions like my wife does, little gym, whatever you have your kids involved in. It's not always easy to carry around Tupperware full of food. I'm going to recommend some easy things for you. First of all, I would recommend you read the Fat Loss Factor book, fatlossfactorbook.com. Why? Because it has good advice on diet theories, on what an essential fat is. It's basically a good background for what tools you need to design your own program. For you, I'd hate to curse because you're a mom, but if you're anything like my wife, you're probably expecting it. My brother has this thing he likes called the ELS diet. It's the eat less shit diet. In other words, and this is kind of eating like a bro or eating clean, so to speak. And I'd hate to say this, but if you control your calories, I doubt you want to sit around and count every calorie you have on Fit Day. That's rough, and with three kids, it's hard to do. What I would recommend is going on and saying, okay, I got breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And it's pretty simple. For breakfast, have a carbohydrate source like whole wheat toast, like a bagel, something like that, with some eggs, maybe two whole eggs. For a snack, a mid-afternoon snack, maybe a banana and some nuts. For lunch, you have a nice, healthy sandwich or a chicken breast or a salad not loaded with dressing. For a snack, again, a piece of fruit, maybe some nuts. And then for dinner, for your last meal of the day, you can have whatever you cook. Try to cook healthier. Try to use less oils. Try to have portion control. Don't go for seconds. And that's a lifestyle diet. Read my book and it'll give you an example of some different foods you can throw in there. And then be creative. Go on Clean Eating. Clean Eating Magazine is a great magazine to get tips on how to cook lighter. Go to Clean Eating, go to their website, and check out what advice they have to make, let's say, a lower fat, lower carb, lower calorie chicken parmesan. At this point in your life, you're not going to want to have three separate dinners, which is the kids' meal, your husband's meal, and then your meal, which is going to be chicken and sweet potato, which would suck. Another thing you need to do, honestly, for energy, exercise. Weight train at least 3 to 4 days a week and do a little bit of cardio. Weight training, I know it's kind of taboo for women, but at the end of the day, weight training is what's going to give you that nice, firm, tight look. Whereas running or walking or doing cardio is going to give you that skinny fat look. And as a male, I can tell you, skinny fat ain't where it's at. I like some junk in my trunk, but I also like a little, you know, tone in there. You know what I'm saying? A little tone. But, Koi, thank you so much for emailing me. I'll get this email to you, the reply, the video, as soon as I can. But you already know that because you're watching it. It's been a long day. Mark Lobiner, TigerFitness.com.